chapter covers four areas related to the study of skin: skin theory, skin care, hair removal, and makeup. We'll begin by studying the theory related to skin care. The study of skin, including its structure, functions, diseases, and treatment, is called dermatology. Skin is the largest body organ, covering the whole body to protect it from invasion from outside particles. Skin has six basic functions: sensation, secretion, absorption, regulation, protection, and excretion. Your textbook has a complete description of each of these functions. Skin has three main layers: the epidermis, which is the outermost layer of the skin, the dermis, which is the underlying or inner layer of the skin, and the subcutaneous, which is located below the dermis layer and composed primarily of fatty tissue. The epidermis is composed of five layers of cells. Each layer has different characteristics. The stratum germinativum is the lowest epidermis level. At this level, mitosis, or cell division, takes place, with basal cells constantly dividing to produce new cells that are pushed to the surface to replace cells that have been shed. Melanocytes are also found in the stratum germinativum. These cells produce melanosomes containing melanin. The amount of melanin present will determine the skin's color. Brown skin contains a large amount of melanin, while skin with little melanin will appear pale or pinkish. The next layer up is the stratum spinosum. It includes cells that have absorbed melanin to distribute pigmentation to other cells. Above that is the stratum granulosum, with granular-like cells that are more regularly shaped. The next area, the stratum lucidum, only appears on the palms of the hands and the soles of the feet. The top layer, the stratum corneum, is the toughest layer of the epidermis and is composed of keratin protein cells that are continually shedding and being replaced by new cells from below. The lower or dermis layer of skin is made up of connective tissues. Also found in the dermis are the sudoriferous or sweat glands. These control and regulate body temperatures, excrete waste products, and help maintain the acidic pH factor of the skin. The dermis layer also contains the sebaceous or oil glands. These glands produce sebum, a complex secretion containing a high percentage of fatty, oily substances. Sebum mixes with the secretion of the sweat glands to produce a layer of oil and moisture that is called the acid mantle. It's the acid mantle that keeps the skin smooth, prevents dirt and grime from entering the outer layer of the epidermis, and also prevents the skin from drying or chapping. Below the dermis is a fatty layer called the subcutaneous tissue, which forms a protective cushion for the skin. It contains large blood vessels that transport nourishment to the skin and nerves. Melanin, produced in the basal layer of the epidermis, protects the skin from the penetration of ultraviolet rays to the deeper layers of the skin. This melanin tans the skin to protect it from the burning rays of the sun. See your textbook for tips on how to reduce the sun's damaging effects on the skin. From a cosmetologist's point of view, the surface of the skin falls into four basic types: dry, oily, normal, and combination. Dry skin is characterized by signs such as peeling and flaking. To make dry skin healthy, soft, and smooth requires treatment with moisture, emollients, and lubricants. Oily skin has an all-over shiny look and or rough texture with blackheads and enlarged pores. It appears in the chin, nose, nasolabial groove, and forehead, which is commonly called the T-zone. Ideal skin is very rare, and its fresh, healthy color and freedom of blemishes is easy to recognize. Care should be simple but consistent and designed to maintain its natural, acid-balanced condition. Combination skin is the most common. It is recognized by the shiny T-zone and, at the same time, the presence of a noticeable dryness in the cheek, jawline, and hairline areas. Combination skin requires the most specialized skin regimen, as treatment must address two different skin types, oily and dry. As a professional, you need to be familiar with skin disorders and diseases so that you can recognize any problems that would prevent you from performing a skincare service. Disease symptoms are classified as subjective, which are those you feel, such as scratching, itching, burning, or pain, and objective, which are those you see, such as pimples or inflammation. Always avoid performing a service on skin that has any of the six signs of infection: pain, swelling, redness, local fever, throbbing, or discharge. Diseases and disorders are often accompanied by skin lesions. As a salon professional, the two categories you will need to recognize are primary and secondary skin lesions. Primary skin lesions include macules, a discoloration appearing on the skin surface. A freckle is an example of a macule. Papules are hardened red elevations of the skin in which no fluid is present. A pimple is an example of a papule. Vesicles are fluid-filled elevations in the skin caused by localized accumulation of fluids or blood just below the epidermis. Herpes simplex, which is also known as fever blisters, is a contagious chronic condition characterized by a single vesicle or a group of vesicles on a red swollen base. No service may be performed when this condition is present. Pustules are small elevations of skin similar to vesicles in size and shape, but which contain pus. A pimple with pus is an example of this. Wheals are a solid formation above the skin, often caused by an insect bite or allergic reaction. Hives, also called urticaria, are an example of wheal lesions. No service may be performed with this condition. Secondary skin lesions appear as the disease advances into later stages of development. Scales are shedding dead cells of the uppermost layer of the epidermis. Psoriasis is identified by round, dry patches of skin covered with rough, silvery scales. It is a chronic condition and not contagious. Crusts are dried masses that are the remains of an oozing sore. A scab on a sore is an example of a crust. Excoriations are mechanical abrasions to the epidermis. A scratch is an example of an excoriation. Fissures, like chapped lips, are cracks in the skin. They may be dry or moist. Scars are formations that result from a lesion. The size and shape of the scar are determined by the extent of the original injury. Ulcers are open lesions visible on the skin surface. They may result in the loss of portions of the dermis and may be accompanied by pus. No service may be performed with this condition. Refer to your textbook for more information on the various skin disorders and diseases, including pigmentation abnormalities and disorders of the sebaceous and sudoriferous glands.